So let's dive into 9 AI tools that you need to be using in 2025. So AI is becoming incredibly useful for our daily productivity and not just administrating our day, but also prioritizing it and getting smaller things done in the background. So I've picked 9 of them that I think you're going to use, and you can find them all linked in the description if you fancy digging into them. So the first of those is one called Sana. Now it's not Asana, it's one called Sana AI. And it is a robust transcription software that is probably the most beautiful, appealing one on the market, but also has some powerful abilities with agents that can work in the background for you after each of the meetings you have. So you take a sales call and you want to be able to do some automation in the background as soon as that sales call is done, so that you don't have to go in and manage that. And that's also a very time-saving thing. But what I like about Sana is it does a full video of the meeting, which you can come back to and find context exactly how it's taken in the meeting, instead of worrying that the source has been adapted, which is an incredibly useful feature. So Sana, probably one of the best live meeting transcribers I've seen on the market. Next one is Zapier's AI agents. This is a fairly new feature and software, but basically what it does is helps you to create a workflow so that you can connect up a bunch of apps that you may already use. What's beneficial about Zapier is it has over 7,000 agents in the background and can be an incredibly helpful way for you to save time connecting those integrations up with the apps you already use. So Zapier AI agents, an interesting software that can help you build that workflow that matters to you. Next up, number 3 is Mindsera. Maybe that's pronounced differently. Mindsera, I don't know. But basically it's a journaling application that uses AI to understand how you're writing in real time. So for example, you could ask it a question or you could tell it something like you would in a journal, and it'll prompt back to you with a question about that to dig deeper. And there are even features like deeper research and insights into your journal so that you can help understand your own problems with the context of AI. And that can be incredibly valuable as sort of like a non-verbal therapist that you can use to unpack some of your thoughts. Now, obviously it won't replace clinical therapists and things like that, but an incredibly useful way to bring that into a system for your habits and journal. Next up, number 4 is another live transcription tool. It's called Granola, which is slightly different. The application is on Mac and allows you to take up to 20 meetings for free, but does have a pro plan to give you unlimited meetings. A lot of people like Granola because what it does very nicely is it works on your device instead of actually having to be a plugin in the meeting, which could potentially be quite awkward when joining the meeting and explaining that this AI software is joining the meeting and you're going to use it to record. Saves you about a minute or 2 probably when you start the meeting. But Granola is a very interesting one for Mac users to save you a bunch of time taking background notes. So if you're interested in joining our 3 apps a week newsletter, you can get it below. I'll introduce 3 new apps to you that you will really enjoy, and I'll pick them every week for you so that you can excel in either AI or new software. So next up is Google AI Studio. This one's incredibly useful if you're somebody that wants to be able to use a map feature and basically get and learn new software. And also there's an interesting one that allows you to use uploads from Google Drive to turn into something valuable. So for example, you can use it to connect up with screen recording to get real-time feedback during your use of an application. So if you're using it with an Excel spreadsheet and you want to be able to get feedback on what numbers are showing on the screen and maybe some calculations that you do in real time, you can use AI to essentially communicate with it because it'll respond back to you and use that technology. And I think the interruption technology isn't as good, but the speed in which it replies to you is probably one of the best I've seen on the market. So well worth a consideration. They also have that maps ability for you to prompt up finding a location that you might want to go to, as well as a cool way to take a Google Drive file, transcribe it instantly, which could save you a lot of time and effort if you use Google Drive, that is. So next up is another one called Lex. Now Lex is a writing software. It is an interesting one because a lot of people are looking at these writing softwares that can help them write better articles using AI at the same time. But it's not just good for that, it could be good for marketing copy and refining things, because each article you can tailor using the AI to get the best results. So sort of like fine-tuning the AI each time you're writing a document can help you produce better results or what you're trying to achieve, whether it's SEO or whether it's better marketing copy for your website, or even putting together a new proposal to a company that you're working with. The concept is very interesting, and they've recently added the ability to search the web and research as well without leaving Lex as well. So if you're looking for a more robust AI writing tool, this could be the one for you. Next up is Superhuman AI. Now Superhuman is a a powerful email app and they constantly add new AI features to make life easier. There's a recent feature called Ask AI, which allows you to actually correspond with your email in a very fast fashion. I am finding I use this all the time because, for example, I don't want to sift through my email to find something. So I'll say, who was last interested in the software I'm trying to sell? Then I can see the conversations that are curated and brought up across all of my email account, which is incredibly valuable for me. So onto our final two. Again, if you're interested in diving into three new tools in your inbox every week, you can find that in the link description below. So Motion is an interesting task management software that is good not only for teams, but individuals as well. Motion allows you to add tasks, and that context you add to the tasks helps to organize it into the priority that it thinks is most suitable for you. So this software, a very useful one if you're interested in prioritizing your tasks and getting more done. Final app on our list is one called Endel. Now this uses AI and a smart algorithm to learn things like your circadian rhythm, location, how much you've slept, your heart rate, all these different health factors. And it builds a music around that, which is very interesting because it can help with your focus, your sleep, your relaxation by tuning the sounds to your day and your body, which is and sounds very weird. And it does, for example, might be like a placebo effect for some people, but I've been using it for a while now, probably about 5 years, and find that it actually does a really good job of that, getting me into flow state better and helping me to work faster. I also use it for sleep as well, and it creates a sound sleepscape for me to just relax. And it's weird because I make sure I don't turn that sleep sound in the car because it makes me feel very tired. Maybe it's just me getting into the habits of it, but very interesting AI app at that. So if you're interested in downloading any of these apps, you can find them in the description below. And of course, if you're searching for more tools and resources, jump over to toolfinder.co. You'll find loads of them, and I'd love to have you over there. So AI tools, there's loads of them, but we'll help you find the best ones. Thanks very much, everyone. Make sure to have a great day, keep productive, and I'll see you very soon. Cheerio.